City of Houston, Chief of Police. But I am a son of Houston. And what people need to understand, first of all, if you cannot see and feel 44 years of pain and suffering from this family, you're not human. You're not human. I'm a son of Houston. And when one of us hurt, all of us hurt. But let me tell you something. I'm not here to say that I understand the pain of a mother, a sister, a nephew, a cousin, an aunt. But I am so honored to be here today. I know you. People that don't know me on the front line of any major protest, where have I been? That's where I met you. There is a spiritual connection with me, with this family. And I'm telling y'all, thank you so much. I'm so proud of y'all. Because you never let your brother's death murder. And let me understand, because there's been some chatter in the neighborhoods about how Chief Finner feel about this. That's a straight up murder.
Yes.
Of somebody else. You got five officers, five, sworn to protect and serve, and murdered an active military soldier. And that hurts. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna apologize today, and that's what I came here for. I said nobody, and I share this with you, nobody has more pain than a mother. 44 years. And I know this little apology for me, and I'm calling it little, because it should have happened a long time ago. And I didn't know about it. The first week I got sworn in, I don't know who it was, called my office and said that the city of Houston, the Houston Police Department, after all this time, had never gave a formal apology to the family. That week, that Saturday, was some kind of event because I didn't have your number. I showed up to that event because I said, look, wherever you want to do it and when, I'm there. And we had an apology on Memorial Day at the Veterans Cemetery. But the most important person wasn't there. And I said, you know what? Whenever mom is feeling better, whenever mom will have me, I'm going to stand with mom and I'm going to stand with this family, and we're going to do an official public apology. And I stand here today, but it don't end today. It's about us working together. It's about me listening to you. It's about me giving you a seat at the table at 1200 Travis and any other activists or any other family that's hurt behind the injustice of some police officers. Because if we don't make it right, that's on us. I stand with this family, and I stand with all families who have suffered the injustices of police officers who said and held up a right hand, I'm a servant, I'm a protector, and I'm gonna protect the constitutional rights. And for me to read the history, and I don't want to be too long, but I want y'all to feel my heart. For me to read that history and our court system at that time, 1 year probation, $1. It's time out for people to devalue certain people because of their race or whatever's going on in their minds. We're all the same. We should be treated as such. And if a police officer violates somebody's rights and they kill them, murder them, they should be treated just as any other citizen. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. So I want to take this time to pause and say, look, I am honored to be here. I'm honored that y'all would allow me to come here and spend this time with the family. It means something to Troy Finner. So on behalf of this entire city, on behalf of the police department, I apologize to this family. and anything that I can do. I cannot take away the pain. Only God. Something like this that happens to a family, when you transition to what he promised us, that's when that pain will leave. It will not leave on this side of this earth, and I know that. But I'm here as your chief to let you know I'm standing with you and whatever you need me to do. And the final thing I'm going to say, there's been a lot of monuments erected throughout our city. I don't know if I've seen one with Joe Campos Torres' name on it. I'm standing with you. We're going to get that done. I've talked. I'm not here to take up for the mayor, but let me tell you something. I spoke to him yesterday. He wanted to be here, but look, I'm going to let him talk to you guys in person. But he's in support of us making sure that this name does not die. And we give proper respect to him and his family in erecting a monument. And I want to work with the family because I don't want to get ahead of you guys. I want whatever y'all want. But I think it's fitting and I think we need to be working together to get that done. So thank God for this day. Thank God for this community. And most importantly, thank God for this beautiful family. And I'm telling you, Mom, it means so much for me to look you in the eye, face to face, and heart to heart, and say I apologize. I thank you so much. I thank God for allowing me to be here. So, hey, I love you, and I know we just meeting, but you got another son, okay? All right, love you.